Well, that's a good thing.
There's a lot more snow in this story. Princess Anna, thinking this entire mess was her fault.
Because it was.
Went out into the blizzard to find her sister, which she did.
They reached the North Mountain.
Yes.
The queen. No.
She felt a castle.
She felt a castle.
Anna was wondering if you've seen Elsa. We don't want her to miss the Arendelle Festival.
Well, not that I remember.
I don't think we'd remember seeing the Queen of Arendelle.
Right. Just do me a favor and keep an eye out for her.
Okay. Anything for you, Mr. Reindeer King?
It's just Kristoff.
And speaking of reindeer, where is Sven? We barely recognized you without him.
Well, Sven found himself some carrots, but, you know, I couldn't help but overhearing your story.
We couldn't help oversmelling you.
You know, I did help Anna a lot. Without me, she would have never made it to the North Mountain.
Okay, and not to mention, you like her.
No, that had nothing to do with it. There was a blizzard. There was ice everywhere. I sell ice. You see the problem?
Nope.
I had to help Anna to save my business.
Kristoff, I think you're forgetting that Arnie and I know the truth about you and Anna.
I have to get back to Anna.
I knew it.
To find Elsa.
Okay, bye. He's dreaming too.
What, you think he's dreaming?
Yes.
And they think he's dreaming?
Yes.
How come nobody thinks I'm dreaming?
You are.
Do you have a
Okay, back to the story.
Get me away from here.
Princess Anna, with the help of Sven and Kristoff, started the long, cold journey toward the North Mountain. Now they navigated deep and dark woods where wolves attacked their sled.
Werewolves.
Not werewolves, just wolves.
Just wolves.
Okay.
They lose his freshly lacquered sled in the process. The sled explodes like sleds do. It sounds like somebody dropped a house on your sister. So they continued on foot.
And then they came across this beautiful glen, and it was so romantic!
Oh, the hero enters. He's an awesome talking snowman whose name is...
Olaf!
Yes! He loves warm hugs in summer!
How can you not love this guy?
Summer? Oh, I don't know why, but I've always loved the idea of summer and sun and all things hot.
Really? I'm guessing you don't have much experience with heat.
Nope. But sometimes I like to close my eyes and imagine what it'd be like when summer does come. Bees will buzz, kids will blow dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. I drink in my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. I'll finally see a summer breeze blow away a winter storm, and find out what happens to solid water when it gets warm. And I can't wait to see what my buddies all think of me. Just imagine how much cooler I'll be in summer. The hot and the cold are both so intense, put them together, it just makes sense. Winter's a good time to stay in and cuddle, but put me in summer and I'll be a happy snowman. When life gets rough, I like to hold on to my dream of relaxing in the summer sun, just letting off steam. Oh, the sky will be blue, and you guys will be there too. When I finally do what frozen things do in summer.
I'm gonna tell him.
Don't you dare.
Summertime.
He does. And speaking of time, we're running out of it. We've got to hurry up and finish this.
Let's go.
Okay. Olaf, Anna, Sven, and Kristoff make their way up to Elsa's castle on the North Mountain.
She tells Anna to go away, freezing her heart.
Accidentally.
Then she learns of Arendelle's fate.
She sends Marshmallow after them, and Kristoff and Anna almost die jumping off of a cliff, but there was snow there to break their fall.
Wait a minute, Olaf has no skull and no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
Anna's hair starts to turn white, so Kristoff takes her to see the love expert.
She's getting colder. Grandpappy says,
only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
He's British?
He's a Rolling Stone.
So they race off to Arendelle to find Hans, so he can melt Anna's heart with true love's kiss. See true love?
Leads a group of men to capture Elsa. Why, Hans? Why?
But Kristoff gets on in Hans, and he leans in to kiss her and save the day when...
He laughs in her face.
He laughs in her. Wait, what? Hans is the bad guy?
Yeah, he's all...
Hans is the bad guy!
Did you sleep through Arendelle History 101?
Pretty much all of college. Well, Elsa escapes her prison. She's running across the fjord with Hans in hot pursuit, and Olaf goes to Anna's rescue.
Helping her realize that Kristoff, not Hans, is her true love.
No, Anna's out on the frozen fjord, and she is running towards Kristoff. Well, she's shuffling.
So cold, so cold.
And she sees Hans about to kill her sister, who has a migraine. Does she save herself? Does she save her sister? What to do?
Olaf kisses Anna.
What?
Oh yeah.
Right.
Everyone lives happily ever after.
Because some people are worth melting for. The end!
The crowd goes wild!
Hi.
Kristoff.
Hello again.
Hello. Did you find your sister yet?
Well, we're still kind of looking for her.
Something's happened.
It's getting cold in here. That can only mean one thing.
Oh, I hope so. Then we can really celebrate the Arendelle Festival.
And that was a very good story you told. Though the ending felt strange.
Oh. Well, Olaf did help a lot.
Anna, you saved our whole kingdom. You saved your sister and yourself.
An act of true love will thaw a frozen heart.
You're my sister.